Good afternoon. This is Brian Ho, Department for Climate Change and Sustainability from Ernst & Young, and we call EY now. So EY actually, for those who don't know, is a so-called a big four accounting firm. So today we'd like to share a really hot topic today is on environmental and social and governance, ESG. So it is a hot topic for the capital market here in Hong Kong, in the Greater China region, and also around the world as well. So this topic is booming, and we are seeing that there are more and more investors, companies talking about ESG. But another question comes out is that whether there are sufficient talent in the market who can support the growth of this ESG trend. So I would like to share with you some of my ideas, some of my observation here in the region, so that we can think about what will be the next step for Hong Kong and also for the region to develop such those talents in the market. So here's the overview of what I'm going to share with you. So the first question you may wonder, why a big four accounting firm will set up a team on sustainability? Because we are seeing the demand. I mean, in the past, many companies or investors, they only look at financial information, but non-financial information, especially on sustainability and ESG, are getting more and more attention in the capital market. And that's why EY set up a team dedicated on sustainability and ESG. And we offer different types of services, like on non-financial reporting, climate change, and green finance. And you can see that these topics are closely related to the demand of capital market nowadays, which investors are looking for sustainable and long-term value from listed company. And this you can see that this kind of services are most related to the capital market, and it is also something. This is also related to what we are talking about today on the emerging ESG trend. In the past 20 years, we are seeing that there are more and more asset owners and asset managers talking about ESG because they want to seek for a sustainable growth from their investees. So international investors, they are besides from looking at companies, their investees' financial performance, they're also looking at how those companies manage emerging risks, which is the environmental and social risks. So due to this kind of demand, we are seeing that locally in Hong Kong, in Greater China, and also in other part of the world, the regulators like the exchange or the SFC in Hong Kong, they are pushing more and more on this topic, on ESG, encouraging investors to look at ESG, requiring listed companies to look at ESG. On the other hand, due to this kind of demand, we are seeing that there are different payers that evolve. For example, like we are seeing different types of rating agencies, information providers that provide financial information, traditionally like MSCI, like Bloomberg, like S&P. Now they are also offering information on ESG. So we can see that this kind of emerging trend happened globally and also here in Hong Kong and the Greater China region as well. In such, an ESG ecosystem is created because we see the investor demands. We also see that the listed companies, the investors also need to respond to those demands. That's why we see that there are lots of initiatives, lots of players that are being involved in this ecosystem. For example, as mentioned, different rating agencies, different consulting firms, different types of service provider. So we can see that this ecosystem is booming, and there are a lot more and more players in the world. So this is a capture from the World Economic Forum to show you about how the ESG ecosystem works. So as this topic is booming in a very relatively short period of time, one question that we need to ask ourselves is that, is there enough talent in the market that can serve the current market demand? Because this is a relatively new topic, as mentioned, around 10 to 15 years ago, there's not so many people talk about ESG. For example, myself, I've been working in the industry for 18 years, and I can see that in the past 3 to 4 years, there was a really big change. So how can we make sure that there are enough talent in the market? Of course, like in Hong Kong, we are seeing different universities, like the University of Science and Technologies have been training undergraduate students on this topic. But I believe that this is far not that enough. So for professionals who have been working in the environmental field or with science background, I believe that there are several skills that we can look at. We can try to see whether we can improve so that we can meet the market demand for talent on the ESG market. First is on business acumen, because ESG actually within the companies or within the investor is a really cross-sectional, cross-departmental collaboration. It's not only about technical, but also about the business, how to communicate sustainability, ESG to the management, to the investors. So whether those talent understand what business is really going on is something that is really important. Second is on communication skills. Besides some technical skills, for those who work in the ESG sector, we really need to have good communication skills to collaborate with other departments within a business organization. Because you can imagine, when we talk about ESG of a companies, it doesn't only relate to one department. There's also, this is about operational level, different type of aspect that you need to coordinate with the company secretary, coordinate with the HR, production, engineering, different types of department. So this is something that the communication skills is really essential for a talent in this industry. And second, and the third one is about sustainability data, because we are seeing that in the ESG world, the ESG data is getting more and more important. Such as in the capital market, we always look at the financial data, and the ESG data, the importance of ESG data is also getting to that level gradually. So how, for a person, for a professional who work in this industry, whether he or she has the sensitivity of the data, how to analyze those data with our financial performance, it is also something that is essential for a ESG tenant. And the last one is the digital skills, because we are talking about digital, and ESG sustainability is also about innovation. How we can leverage digital skills and know more about digital skills and help our no matter the companies or the investors to kind of do the transformation to catch the changing world, especially now we are talking more and more about on climate change, on different types of risks that will affect or that will impact the business operation. So I believe that these are the market demand, what types of talent that the ESG sectors are looking for. So how to get prepared? Of course, on one hand, I believe that no matter educational institutions like universities, there are programs to be offered. But on the other hand, I believe that professionals who are interested in getting into the industries or working internally within the companies on ESG, there are several things to think about. First is, what is the entry point? This is mainly for the environmental graduate students. So there are, as mentioned, lots of more and more opportunities in the market at the moment. For example, like our team, we are hiring 10 full-time staff per year and 15 interns per year. And I believe that other firms are doing so. So for undergraduates who want to get prepared in the industry, you can look for different opportunities. For example, whether you can be an intern when you are still studying to get more experience. And also, because the ESG ecosystem has been established, so we are seeing that there are different new opportunities coming up as well. For example, from consulting firms, from rating agencies, and from in-house practitioners. We are seeing that different types of organizations, they are hiring people. So what will be the first choice for that? I believe that it depends on the experience. But for fresh graduates, I believe that consulting firm or rating agency will be your first choice, because it will be easier to get into, and it will be also a good platform for the students, undergraduate students, to gain experience. And the third one is, what extra skills you need. So I always talk to people who want to participate in the industries. Besides from technical skills, those skills that we mentioned earlier is very important. Communication skills, understand the business, and more importantly, we need to use business language to interpret all the sustainability terms and ESG. Because, for example, myself, I always talk to the board of directors of different listed companies. If we only talk about sustainability, they may not be interested to listen. But when we talk about ESG, when we talk about sustainability, what's the business value? After doing that, how the listed companies can create value by, for example, like improve their rating or attract more investors who cares about ESG. It is something that the business language that I believe the talent should have to in order to get succeed in the industry. So this is the end of my sharing, and I hope that by share this topic, we will have more thinking about what types of talent we need for Hong Kong, for the Greater China region, and also for the world to cope with this ESG emerging trend. Thank you.